Hi, welcome to the map tutorial, Single Axis. In this video, we'll be learning how to prepare a motion control axis for operation quickly and easily using mapp. As you can see, I've already prepared a sample project. It's a basic setup with an X20 controller. In order for us to configure the axis and do things like set limits for speed and acceleration, we first need to add a map axis configuration object. In this object, we can expand the structure to see the relevant axis parameters. Each configuration object needs to have a unique name, known as a map link, which in this case I'll call glink conveyor. We'll need this later during programming. In order to use the available map functions, we're going to need a program. I'm using ladder diagram, but of course, with map, you're free to use any programming language you like. I'm going to call my program conveyor. Now we just have to add our map component. It's a single axis application, so we should use the component MpAxis basic. After creating an instance, we need to connect all the relevant inputs. The first is what's called the map link. With this, we establish the connection to the configuration object that we created, named glink conveyor. We'll enable the component by setting the enable input. Values such as the axis velocity or direction of rotation can be changed during runtime using the parameter input. In the data structure MpAxis basic par type, I'll change the default initial values for acceleration, deceleration, and velocity by a factor of 10. The last input that we need to connect is the axis input, which is also known as the axis reference. This input establishes the connection between the software and the hardware. Now we want to start the axis. We'll turn on monitor mode so that we can manually set commands. First, we'll switch on the controller. Then we'll home the axis. The outputs of the MpAxis basic component show us whether these actions are successful. Using the move velocity command, we can start a movement with the parameter settings we made. And look at that, the axis is turning. A core feature of MAP is the ability to perform diagnostics and configuration via a web browser using the MAP service Web Access. To get to this page, simply open the browser and enter the IP address of the controller followed by /map. On the left, you'll see a list of all the MAP components that are currently enabled. Each component is now sending all of its live data to the web browser. This allows you to perform reliable diagnostics at the application level very quickly without needing any special tools. You can even dive in a level deeper and expand the infrastructure, for example, to check out the current state in the PLC open state diagram. As you can see, map components are extremely easy to use, configure, and diagnose. Thanks for watching.